Now, there are a lot of things that you need to see, which you can see online. The Moai Trust is online. You can see the sites all over, following the whole process. So everything is transparent, and he's been around with all the wakamininga, all the taumata, and he conducted this at Waitangi. We had our first court hearing in the paramata of Waitangi, which was the first court in paramata in Aotearoa on February the 4th. We actually had a live case, and they asked me to be the presiding judge on that day. So I facilitated that. Then on February the 6th, we opened up the Native Māori Grand Jury Court, and it was authenticated by the 21 Gun Salute, which is the Navy. So that was all done. So now we are bringing the information back here, and I said to them, I would love to have you at our marae so we can give the information out, and we will be a part of this body to see it go forward. We had the opportunity, Heniweni and I, because we've been in the Hokomininga, and we've been in the Taumata, and we are now in the Māori government and the Māori Paramata. And we've sort of been a part of it, and now it's time to support it. This is our kiwaha, if you like. It's our catch word or catch cry. Amorangi ki mua, hāpai o ki muri. We said everything that carries on within our district, like the trust board, let them go ahead and do what they have to do. It doesn't affect what we're doing. But things that moving forward and going forward is where we want to be. So we support everything that's going forward. Doesn't affect anybody financially, physically, mentally, or anything otherwise. So it's an opportunity to be a part of. If it doesn't work out, you lose nothing. But if it comes off, you have everything to gain. And that's where I am. I'm looking at the gain and not the losses. We haven't got anything yet, but there's an opportunity that it may come our way because of the work that these people have done. And all we've done is support them. So I'm going to read this. And this is, I'm going to leave this, this is for the marae, so that you've got a copy of what this is about. It's King Native Bench Court and Grand Jury Rules. The authority comes from the Native Court that has existed since 1834 in Kororareka, Russell, Bay of Islands. For 183 years at the anniversary date, 20th of March 2017, on the 20th March 1834, the British, with the King William the Fourth Authority, gave us their flag and the right to trade to the four corners of the earth, but left the Native Court behind in Kororareka, as they already had a court system operating. We moved the Native Court 6th of February 2017 from Kororareka, Russell, Bay of Islands to Te Ti Marae, Waitangi, and proclaimed the lands of Aotea, New Zealand, and the Pacific Islands belongs to the He Hakamininga chiefs, or Ngā Hapū, and not to the King and Queen of England, nor the King and Queen of Spain. We raised our surrogate King John Wanoa to speak for the silent King William the Fourth under the Moai Crown and King William the Fourth Trust, kingdom to kingdom, monarchy to monarchy. We opened the King's Native Bench Court for business and asserted our sovereign authority absolute, affirming our right to self-determine our right to trade and to manage our lands, natural resources, our affairs, and our people according to chiefs and hapū. The 1834 Hakamininga flag is a commercial contract on the sea of Admiralty. Partnership with the British Royal Navy as protectorate to any threat against our self-determination. King William IV gave us the King Tawhito pound note currency, and on 15 April 2016 at Te Ti Marae, we lawfully enacted the right to use our currency now hooked up to the ANZ Bank and our share system, moaipowerhouse.com. The shares are distributed to all the beneficiaries equally and to all Moai members throughout the world. As the owners of all the revenue through our registry as shareholders, owners, beneficiaries, members, the ground rent chief as creditor, sheriff and registrar as the authorised person to collect the rents and leases of the King lands to be distributed to the shareholders, owners, beneficiaries, members equally. The King William IV seal authenticates our documents. The Moai Tahitian Polynesian seal authenticates our native title. Māori, New South Wales and the New Zealand government, along with the Queen and third party to this private commercial contract and our debtors. Our 1834 Hea Whakamininga flag is a private commercial contract that no third party can enter into. Our finance system, we are not in debt. We are in a credit system only. We don't use land as collateral. We don't borrow. We only use our own energy and resources. It is a system to balance creditors and debtors. These are legal claims inside the jurisdiction of the King's Native Bench Court Authority. We are offering an alternative system to the debt-ridden system designed to create more debt, usurping our natural resources, our rights, our lands, our wealth, and our inheritance, and at worst upon our people, depriving our children. We recompense through the district courts recovery and salvage for the damages which benefits hapū and whānau direct to Britain. The British are responsible for our security and protection of our financial investment interest in land in this private commercial contract. These steps progress further than the treaty claims of 1% of our worth. Our intent is to the claim that which exists in the 1834 private commercial contract for 100% for the exploitation of our natural resources, land, degradation and damages claims against our people. We are running this through the British system that has existed for 183 years and reached this point in time. We are ready to whack the tail of the fish back into life, off into the sea of admiralty. All native courts have to be inducted to be able to use this King's Native Bench Court authority effectively and to adjudicate the hearings. All native courts require a scribe to record the wishes of hapū and chiefs, the time of native court hearings, the venue, the people in attendance, the hapū and the outcome of the native court decisions. All native courts must return annually to the King's Bench Native Court Grand Jury at Te Timarae grounds in front of the ancestral Pau Whenua on the anniversary date, 20th of March every year thereafter, as all outcomes will be placed into the official record for all hapū to hear and receive. The King's Native Bench Court Grand Jury will vote on the wishes of chiefs and hapū. The presiding judge officiates the decision and the judge determines the decision upon the facts and valid claims. All debts recovered are automatically credited as equal shares to all beneficiaries and shareholders, members as owners of the wealth. All those who refuse to pay, we can now seize it or authorise it, a writ of execution warrant. We are asking to validate the steps we have taken to proclaim and affirm that the lands of Aotearoa, New Zealand and the Pacific Islands belong to the Hea Whakamininga chiefs and the revenue to the shareholders and beneficiaries, members as owners, and assert our sovereign authority inside the King's Native Bench Court as being true, valid and immediately effective. We are also asking that we affirm our rights to self-determination, our right to trade, to manage our lands, our natural resources, our affairs and our people. As the absolute sovereign authority in Aotearoa, New Zealand and the Pacific Islands, our scribe will record this event and the grand jury present as living witnesses to this event and our proclamation affirmed by the chiefs, the whānau, the hapū, the people on the 16th day in the month of February in the year of our Lord 2017. This is truthfully the first test case at this highest authority to make sure it is sound implementing this system. All those in agreement say aye.
Aye.
Aye. So I give this to you as the chairman of the Marae for your perusal and your research house, we don't want to wait around, because while we are waiting around, things keep moving on, and that's where we want to be. We want to move on and hope that the benefits will come back to our marae, every marae in Aotearoa, and that our grandchildren and children don't have to go through all the stuff that we're trying to get done today in the future. So, Elijah, there you are.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Tēnā koe. Any questions? Any questions?
Who are we supposed to be collecting the debts?
John?
Yeah. I just say here, on an individual case by case of one person versus the other, on a claim of any sort, of any case, even treaty claims. It's anything of land or any damages in Admiralty law that is locked. And we have a case against the Crown itself directly, but the Crown is not a living person. It's the director or the trustee that is responsible with the checkbook. So we are only taking one person that's responsible for all its operations in commercial contract or a company. The director or the trustee is the one that we are heading to see whose title stands up the strongest. So when it comes to whakapapa, a title will always be on the document. If it's a deed, it is a British title. That's the one overruling a or birth certificate. As a British birth certificate is a title. If you can prove I was here and I didn't see you. Okay?
Okay. Anybody else follows?
The burden of proof.
Okay. Hang on. Yep.
Who are we supposed to be collecting the debts from?
Okay, we're taking the debts from the Crown agent, who is responsible for what you've missed or lost, and make him accountable. Someone, a live person, is accountable to you, one at a time, not the whole tribe. Okay, that's why I say by individual case, it's one on one. My word against your word on this court. Okay? So the burden of proof is who has stronger evidence. I won a case against a big block of land in Auckland opposite the Sky Tower. That's going to be a test case where the CIB police lost against me because the judge said they had insufficient evidence against this. Just this gap with the badge on top. And they flag the way, the right legal way to use it. Okay, so that if you can convince the Crown that you have a superior title, that's one thing. If you have evidence, that's another to support your case. So the more evidence you got in a case against someone, in a grand jury case, the grand jury will make the last say before it's handed over to the presiding judge here. In a native court sense, it's native land we're talking about. Not any other land. It's got a British title on it, not the New South Wales title. We're talking about British land titles here, with this British flag. Okay? Is that fair?
Yeah, and in the case of what I'm on the specific saying, in terms of the debt to us, we didn't have a debt, but we lost land.
Yes.
That land equated to a distinguishment of our native title to that land.
Okay.
That's really what I think.
I'll explain that. It's the Queen's Crown, Queen Victoria and Queen Elizabeth extinguished the title. That's that crown on the Queen's side. But the King's is still there. I'm saying the King, we have the right to challenge the Queen's side of the crown against this King's crown with the hapū, not the iwi. The hapū.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah, because the gift I'm thinking the same thing, the fact that we lost all our titles because it was given to individuals, three individuals, and the three individuals had the right to put it in, to distinguish the native title, because it will belong to the whole tribe, but it's only not to put the apologies.
Yeah.
They've apologized.
Yeah.
And yet, if you really want to talk about a debt, always you could go to the bank or the findings of Nachikuri and you'll find all apologies to what they did.
Yeah.
But you see, that's all it is. It's got the apology that no substance.
Yeah.
So what I'm hearing you for saying is you may have substance in terms of putting a case together that can actually get the, because most of those lands that went into the three individuals went, got identified that the daily did, went into another tribe,
yeah,
which became the majority shareholders,
yeah,
of that of the land. This is with not to do the ground within ourselves.
Yeah, so that's why I say on an individual case basis,
yeah,
of whakapapa title in a native court, because the native will decide that in this lawyer, and that becomes fact against a alien title, which is this one. Okay, so we're only saying that what they took off the land is this one. What they took this around the world, they did it with other countries of indigenous the same way. The king's bench court took all the wealth exactly the same, but we put a value on what's missing in the value of your place.
And just in general, your discussion is when you make a comment like in the world, they'll carry on.
Yeah, they'll carry on.
They carry on now.
Yeah.
And some of their stuff are really, they've done most of the damage on Article 2 now. Some of the Article 3 stuff.
So what I'm saying is the Queen, we don't go near their acts, we challenge their acts.
Mm-hmm.
We challenge the whole system with these acts of King. A King is honest. What the King says goes.
Yeah.
That's why I'm having no problem with the Crown saying nothing and the police saying nothing. Because they can't say anything against the King. This is the most powerful flag in the world of commerce and bank and land. This is a mortgage flag that can take your land off you.
That
belongs to a conglomerate business company.
Yeah.
And so that's another matter. We're only dealing with the lands now rather than hit that one. What happens is we do one case. If I take Cook Street, I can take Cook Street.
Yeah.
It will take the whole country one shot with this. Okay? That annihilates all the titles if we go. And Napui is looking at that now. They're reading into it. What I'm saying, to satisfy themselves if it works, because it's on, this flag is on their land. They put it there, see?
Yeah.
And so we have to look at other pieces of land on how to interpret this law on that land, you see?
That comment you made about this one world order, because everybody's watching the one world order,
yeah.
Not you.
Yeah.
We're all watching.
Yep.
I'm not quite sure which was one world order. One world order that's going to be the consortium of one world order of the multi corporates, or is it going to be a which side of the
monarchy,
order?
Monarchy or the
which side of the order are you talking about? The
that's the new world order.
So one world order is part of the whole economy. That's going that way anyway.
Who owns the New World Order and the Vatican is the Dutch, King William III and King William IV. The Dutch owns the Vatican, and that's no. And so we're claiming what's on this flag as being the creditor of all that wealth. So we're testing them out.
What I'm saying is, in terms of Māori tikanga, in terms of our tikanga, we can't become part of any one world order. That's it. We are ticking it to ourselves.
It defaults because they got the money to shoot anybody with this. This is shooting us questions up, Lord. It's a declaration of war flag. That's when you look at it that way. They put a cordon over your country and take it off you. But I'm saying the value of all the commerce in the world is 970 million trillion pounds. That's what its value is in terms of 1834 to 2017, inclusive. That's a World Bank figure. That's calculated in where we're going, how much it's worth to us. You're 0.14% worth the value of what we can recover in any square inch of land. That they did the same to everybody else is a uniform figure right across the board. So no one's different to the other. All this land is going to have the same value. That, like right now, Don Trump is saying all the currency is going to be the same value and it's going to be one world order. He's saying that because the Queen is telling him to say that. And so he's taking the thunder out of that one. You see? But you read into it what Donald Trump is saying. Because he's been put there to take us over in our trust. The Queen Victoria Trust belongs to us. We are the beneficiaries. We still are paying into it. We should be collecting, not paying. No? I'm saying the value of each person.
They say each person.
Yeah, we are numbers in their game. It's a game. We're only numbers. And you haven't got enough Maoris. See? We're outnumbered. Every time, the Maori Party or any party, we're outnumbered. By the corporate. They own everything. Your land belongs to them. The lead. And you go for everything until this is one way to kill a cat, a rat. Yeah, they want it. They want it.
We're dealing with that, I think, lumbering in terms of the...
The fracking and all the rest. They're going to drill holes in anything they want, whether it's got a tikanga on it or not. Their law, they're using the King's law, not the Queen's law. She hasn't got this law. The King, only a King can undo a King. That's why they're calling me King John in England when I put that off. That's a fact now. Only on paper. Because we are allowed to do that as a contract partner. Yeah. I'm just saying...
In terms of what's taking place today here, what you discussed, what we heard, but we really got to have something tangible that we can line up what you're saying. It's something that we really need to get a grasp of. I think I'll get a pretty much clear indication of where this is. At the end of the day, there is pute somewhere.
Yeah.
And this is what this is all about, really. It's about the pute that's been locked up somewhere.
Yeah. So the pute is right in front of us on the sea where they're taking it. We just build that. Who's taking the fish? That's a bill. Who is messing the land and the sea up and the fracking? That we put a bill from here. And we're going to test. We've got to prove it first. Before anybody.
I think this, so they understand the actual establishment of the native Māori Grand Jury Court is the first immediate point whereby we can start accessing what is ours within our rights.
Read into it.
That's the first point. The next thing is the government, next thing is the parliament. And that's how we have to set up.
I can never get a grasp of anything unless I sit down and really...
It's a one-on-one. It's a one-on-one.
Until I can do that, I can't give you any indication.
Yeah.
Because I happen to be something that I don't understand.
True. Yeah.
So this is only just a presentation. I'm not expecting you fellas to learn anything right now, because you're going to have to do some homework. And he's given you 80 sites on his website and 139...
930 YouTube videos.
Yeah, YouTube videos for you to do
and have access. It's the British people and others who are reading and saying what's wrong with your people, John. They understand plain English what's going on in the world. Not only here, it affects everyone. If this is fixed, it'll fix the whole world.
And we knew that. That's why I brought it here first. Because I wanted to share it with you now so that at least I can say I've been here. You've seen seen it. Now, you go and read up on it. We've given you access to all that YouTube stuff and videos, access to it. And that's what I brought back for you to do. Because these guys are, you know, the explanation, that they become so vast because of so much that they have to go through. So what they're saying is, the access is yours to research. So this is why we...
Okay, I'll tell you what happened. Cook Street is 2.5 billion. I'm going to get 2.5 billion on that piece of land, 2.4 hectares.
Yeah.
If I get that, the whole loss is going to take off from that. I have to prove I can get it.
Yeah.
That's the case.
It.
That's the case I'm doing to make sure. The next case was to implement the writ warrant on this. I did it before with you and Marshall, and they failed on me and got locked up. So now I have to go in myself and put it in there. And try.
So in the terms of what you, when you do the case, what were you litigating under, LAW or LARE?
LAW. You've got to be LAW here.
Okay.
Yeah, it's all in LAW.
Okay.
In the both crown systems, both crowns have got to accept the fact that it affects both crowns. You see, you can't be one or the other. It's just got to go through the system backwards. Okay,
so
money he takes care of to make sure it's authentic to go through, but the Crown, he's a JP in the courts, he's got to make sure the documents stack up. Otherwise he wouldn't have sent it in time. But he's got confidence in it. And as long as he's got confidence, it'll work.
So that's the test case.
And myself. I put myself on.
So
when that happens,
then
we've got a benchmark against every title on land to put a value on.
Okay?
So that's where the revenue comes from.
Okay.
No borrowing.
I'd like to introduce you to Winamu. Hedawini. Hedawini. Kia koe.
I'm only supposed to read this out. I haven't got too much to say. Only we had the airport business in Kaikai on, and we beat the government on it. So that's the first step. We beat the government on the Kaikai airport. So we just have that. I just have that announcement to make. Now, I know there's a lot of words that's been passed from one to another this evening, and I've got quite a few things to say, but unfortunately I'm just going to say what's on this paper and sit down, because you've had a long talk, all of you, and taken up much of a lot. Anyway, I go back to the Whakaminaga. Because the Whakaminaga I've been under since 1941. And the other person that was under Whakaminaga in 1941 was Charlie Petra. And we, our battalion was under the Whakaminaga. And all our rules were made up as we went along. And so the colonel, when we were made Whakaminaga, the colonel got us all together and said, now, what law do you want? And he stipulated certain laws, certain things. And you know, everything went well, right to the end of the war. And the only thing that we need to know tonight is that proclamation. We're here to ask is, you are given a total from here, from his own marae, to continue on being a judge. All those in favour, put up your hand and say aye.
Aye.
Have a count. Count it up. Those to the contrary, you say no. The ayes have it. Hello, everybody. I'll read out this proclamation now, and I'll sit down. We, the Tinorongatika, gathered here today in Congress at Te Reo Mihi Marae. On the 16th day of the month, February, in the year of our Lord 2017, proclaim and declare this our truthful sovereign and sovereignty absolute in all the lands 300 nautical miles into the sea, including the continental shelf, surrounding all the islands within Aotearoa New Tirani, under the ownership of the native tangata whenua, ngā whānau, ngā hapu, o Aotearoa o New Tirani. All those in favour, raise their hand. Count. Those to the contrary, say no. The eyes have it, you're a man of captain. Short and sweet.
Joanna, just for a bit of clarity, my name is Dorothy Rollo. Te Mori and Conquer the first inside of that flag is my relation. With a little bit of mamai, my Viking lines in there. Because the mamai, it happened in my Māori side, or my tangata whenua side. What I wanted to tell you is what some people don't know, that all law derives from feudal law, and it's law of the kings and the queens. And not many people know that a feudal ladder exists. When the captain jumps off the ship, it's usually HMS on the ship, His Majesty's ship, or Her Majesty's ship. What not many people know is when they get off that ship, you're also a magistrate. You've got certain legal functions that they're able to do. Now, when they get off and they claim that land belongs to the king, he is then the only one that can grant it away. Now, when he grants it away, he is at the top of the rank. The queen is a vice. Now, when a grant comes direct from a king, the next title down on this feudal ladder is tenant and capitae, or chieftains. Here in Aotearoa, we think our chieftains are at the top of the ladder, but on the feudal ladder, they are second. Now the chieftains can then make a grant, which they did so, unfortunately, through the 1840 treaty. The next level down is called the Mesne Lords, and the Mesne Lords become the governing body. And the governing body is our government today. The next line down, they can have any amount of lords that they want. And those lords are the government departments that we see everywhere collecting revenues of us and of our usury services, because we're usually the ones that work on the land. Now the next level down is the tenants and demesne, and that's who we became. Now, so we are actually paying for the lands that we own back to this governing body that has a higher authority, hence us raising our king, because a queen is ruling over us right now. Now, when she went over to EU Parliament, there's a conflict of interest, because now they have no more queen, head of state, head of the realm New Zealand. And this is our perfect opportunity to raise our surrogate king. And our surrogate king has the highest authority throughout the world, because there are kings inside of that flag. Now, as You were told that King William III created the banks. Anything prior in time has first right. They are also the people who created commercial contracts. Again, anything prior in time has first right. Also, this is the first flag in Aotearoa New Zealand. Again, anything prior in time has first right. The red in the flag is the St. George Cross, and he was the conqueror. He went around conquering the lands. The white, black background on that flag is actually the royal partnership to the Royal Navy. And the blue is representative of the Admiralty law that exists there. That eight-pointed star is the St. Patrick. Bring it up. The eight-pointed star is a St. Patrick Church Order. Now, he said, we've got a secretary. She has a DNA blood claim right to the St. Patrick star. I have a claim right, DNA blood bloodline, to this flag. And the king granted it to us. Now, there's certain other things in law that, in feudal law, that people don't know. One of those things is the word E-N-T-A-I-L that existed way back in the day. Now what that meant when we got this flag is that we could only give the entire gift away or the entire sovereignty away to the heirs of our body only. So our DNA blood bloodline, which the Queen has none. So we could never ever gift away our sovereignty. It was a charade. She needed our consent to be able to do the things that she was doing. Now, inside of the English terminology of the treaty, there's certain words like preemption. That meant she had the prerogative right to purchase the lands before anybody else. And government legislated that out. Everybody knows that the king or the queen is a higher authority than the government. They've been mismanaging our lands. Fitzroy got kicked out, but they've still been mismanaging our lands ever since that time, and they haven't stopped, and they're not going to. So the highest authority inside of this flag, and you need a king to assert that authority. It doesn't work any other way, and this is the reason why we had to raise our surrogate King John Wanoa, and he speaks for the king that is silent because he's passed. But the grant of the king went to he whakaminga o ngā hapu chiefs and the hapu. And that's the only thing that we can do with these lands. Now, the eight-pointed star is the legal, lawful collection of the rents. And the Queen is usurping that. And she's robbing all, not just our nation here, all the indigenous nations of the world. And this protects them also. But we make a precedent case here to be able to protect the other indigenous nations. Now, there's also something that people don't know about a memorial. It means different things in legal terminologies compared to the dum-dum language they teach our kids at school. I say dum-dum language because they wanted us to learn so far. In the legalese language, it means something different. Now, a memorial is a statement, a claim, a right, a fact of an event that has happened. And our memorials are the carved memorials that we bury into our earth and our attachment to our whenua. Now, they made a claim here that they discovered Aotearoa. What many don't know is that the Māori statues that are in representing the Rapa Nui and Raiatea people in the Easter Islands were buried hundreds of years before Pauiri went around any country stabbing any flag, anything prior in time and prior right. So that's our discovery claim, because New Zealand was a part of that original discovery title that that the Māori people or the Māori statute represented, and not many people know that. So the memorial outside of the Waitangi Treaty grounds is again a claim, a right, a statement, a fact of an event that has happened, but it did not come before our memorials. So we claim the native title. What not many people know also is that the Queen has a radical title. You need to look these words up so that you understand what they are. I presume. presumed or an assumed title. We have an Aotearoa title, one that predates hers. It's native all the way. It's indigenous all the way. Now, this isn't just about money. This is about asserting who we are in our tikanga, in the documents, through the flag, because it was given to us, and they're usurping not just our whenua, all the indigenous native nations of the world. So we don't want to just protect here, we want to protect all of them. That discovery title that existed, which was the Macronesians, the Melanesians, the Australians, the USA, there's so many of them that they're ripping off and depriving it, our children, our lands. You know, you've heard all this before. They've committed genocide, treason, just acts that are nasty and, you know, gut-wrenching things that you don't think to do to any person. And we want the chance to be able to say, nah, cut it out, kahore, go away. We're going to do something about them, and we want to do something about them. And that's all I'm asking you to do.
Okay. Any questions on that one there? Squilly, anything? Logan?
Still wrapping my head around it.
That's okay. That's okay. You've got plenty of time. Plenty of time to do that.
And you're welcome to sit on it, you're welcome to go through the sites. But there is just a lot of information that people really don't know anything about. And to really understand what they did to us, we have to understand who they were before they came here. So we'll travel right back in time.
Can you give them the access to those sites?
Facebook.
Facebook?
Just put in MOAI and... you'll see a ton of them come up.
MOAI.
It'll also
Facebook,
tell you about, you know, a lot of the things that I've just said. What some people don't also know is that there's a statute in Chile, and it says that Maui peoples are the same as the Maui tangata whenua peoples, or the Rapanui or Raiatea peoples, tangata whenua, are the same as the New Zealand tangata whenua. So see, these are all claims, right? A claim, a statement of fact, an event that has happened. And that was 1772.
1772. So access to those sites is Moai Facebook.
Even Moai Twitter, Moai YouTube,
Moai.
John Wanoa, any one of those names or sites.
Moai Crown.
Moai
Crown.
Moai Crown. Oh, I have to explain that, Moai Crown.
Yeah, do. And the bank.
Yeah.
The names.
The reason why Moai Crown is because you can't deal with Crown as a tikanga. They're not going to listen. They haven't for 183 years. It's Crown against Crown. As I explained, the king's at the highest, queen's at the vice. We've got the higher authority already, and we know it. And that's why we want to go for gold. Now, government deals with government, as do people deal with people. But we cannot... on these levels, down this feudal ladder, deal with the Queen. She's got us. And she's had us for 183 years. Yeah. Now that native court that we talked about that was stuck over in Kororarika under the tree, what that was the International Native Court sitting there.
Is that why when Tafio and Ratna went to England, that they were refused audience with the Queen in those days? Is that why, probably why, they never...
What?
There's quite a few, yep. You read back in the history, how our people, you know, our rangatira, those days, ventured over to England to seek an audience for the return of our land.
Well, they would have had no chance whatsoever, because on the funeral ladder they said, they're boss.
They were hindered and stopped in every way they could. And that's why in our histories you read about how Ratana visited Japan and all those other places. you know, quite high.
The emperor.
Emperors over
there. Yep. I'll just explain so you can carry on. What it is this. Prior to the Queen Victoria, the kings went back to King Solomon and back to King Solomon's mind started from there, 380 around there. Then it carried on in the emperor, carried to William the Conqueror, and then William the Third and William the Fourth, the Williams. And now they're going to try and put Prince William in or George to take that bloodline, to take the wealth, which was consolidated in King William the Third. All those empires and gold and everything got bundled into a commercial entity that only a king can go. They went there when the queen was there to try and get into it. And it's then again I say this, admiralty is private business between one and the other person and nobody else's business. If you try to talk to the queen, they won't let you in. If they tried to talk to the chief here and the king, no one can get in because of that reason. It is a locked up process. It is a mortgage that you can't get out of, and it sticks like that till the king comes along. But you have to wait for another king to undo it, because the queen cannot undo something higher than her. That's all I'm saying. That's why they keep going back to the UN or to Westminster to try and get access into that trust, because it got queen.
I've heard that there's quite a bit of treasure, there.
Yeah, there's 1.7 million trillion, 1.7 million metric tons of gold sitting in the Philippines and Switzerland and also in Hawaii, but most of the bulk is in the Philippines, and that's our trust being set up over there under the King and Queen of Spain. The trustees, two trustees there, and the other trustee is Prince Andrew, and the other one is King. Queen Elizabeth is the head trust, and that's that trust that belongs to us. No one can get it because it's locked up with the king. Okay, they can't get it. And the admiralty. She's using the admiralty of the king in a king's bench court to lock anybody out of a private contract. That's all it is. That's why they can't get it, because she's hiding behind the king.
So we're waiting for Prince William to come.
No, he's not in the contract. The wrong bloodline. Okay. The wrong bloodline. He's going under the Queen's bloodline. The Queen is not the king. They are secondary, third party to the king's partners. These are the native partners and nobody else in Dubwil. We just nominated the chiefs to go back into contract and pick it up. Pick up that contract from Kororareka. They hid it there. They hid themselves in the Waitangi Marae court, and no one saw it. So all we had to do is claim the court, claim the courthouse, claim the ship of admiralty, claim the flag, claim the king, claim the Moai, claim the memorials back to the native live chiefs, and that's the only way you can get into it.
The Māori Native Grand Jury Court in Waitangi. It stands there today. We've had one already, a court hearing there on the 4th of February, and we've had a hearing here which is facilitating and presentation of what we have brought back here to Te Hapua today. So with that, then it means to go to hoki. Only time will tell. And there's nothing, you know, that's I'm not going to wait for anyone. So, for me, I'd just like to kia koe John, Manahi, the whānau, Dorothy, and o tamātene whānaunga no Rarotonga, tēnā koutou, o te koutou afi, o te manaki. But this is the man with all the mana and the power in Aotearoa today. He's the oldest living sovereign, 28th Māori, Māori Battalion, who served and still living today, and he held the Whakamininga title. That's what they went over as, and he is that living. He's actually the end of all the jury and court decision making in Aotearoa, if not the whole wide world, because of his age. There's nobody that can talk below him or above him, because they have to be at least 93 years old. That's the mana he holds for us. He's important to us, he's important to Ngā Pui Nui Tonu, and he's important to every whānau hapū in Aotearoa Putanō. So I just want to say to you, Herewini, we're very honoured and privileged to have you here supporting this kaupapa in Ngāti Kuri, which you are, and back in our marae today. So, tēnei te mihi aro ki a koe hoki te rana tira. So, e tātou mā, I'm going to ask, ki a koe Manahi, ki tūtuki tēnei kaupapa mō tātou, i raro i te karakia mō tātou, i tēnei o tēnā.
Tēnā tātou tātou, i roro ngā manaakitanga, tō tātou kaihanga. O mutu nā mahi a piriwiri tua mō tēnei haora, mō tēnei pō. Ka tuko mai rā te whakahuki mai rā te wairua ki rutu i a tātou. Me ki tō ture tangata kua mutu, a kua whakakapia tia e tō ture wairua. Ke mōheo mai tātou. Te tangata nei ki runga rau, ki reira hau i tōna taha. Reka huri atu nei rā ki a koe e o koe nā kingi o nā kingi katoa. O koe te Māori o nā Māori katoa. O koe te kawenata o nā kawenata katoa. O koe te triti o nā triti katoa. Nōrera he honore he krōria kia tō ingoa, i nā wā katoa. Ei hoa nā mano, e tūnei mātou e raro tēnei whare, o nā tūpuna o tēnei wāhi. Kā huri atu rāna whakaro ki tō mānga e tono mai rā koe mō mātou i te iwi morehu. E hi koe ana e i taua wā e rungi te mātou ta whenua taino mai rā ki te reringa wairua. Nā tō mana, nā tō